Hello, air sign, and welcome back to my channel. This is your not next 48. This is a pop-up love reading. I think I said next 48 on the fire sign one. I'm sorry. So this is a pop-up love reading for air sign. What the hell? Are you watching the next 48 or the first 48? So this is for Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius. Let's see what's popping up for you in love. All right, if you have questions about getting a reading, check that description box. Everything is there. What you see is what you get. All right, so let's see. Pop-up reading for love. For air sign. Okay, Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius. What is popping up for love for you? Okay, so there you are, popping up strong. Okay, we have the Page of Swords. You could be dealing with another air sign, but that is your energy. All right, being cut and dry, being straight to the point. All right, being clear about what you want, or somebody's being very clear with you. All right, if you're dealing with someone who is like this, this person, I'm getting the Page of Swords. It always comes off as someone who can't really speak well, someone who has a hard time articulating, or this could be somebody with a speech impediment. Like, they have a hard time communicating, but I'm not getting that with this. I'm getting someone who's actually a lot more mature than what they come off as. They're very mature for their age. Okay, we have the Fool card. We have the Two of Wands. All right, so I'm getting a lot of youthful energy in this reading already. So you could be dealing with somebody who's a lot younger than you, or maybe you are dating someone that you're dating, like the youngest person you've ever dated, possibly. They don't have to be super young, but I'm getting this is the youngest that you've ever gone, or something like that. And it's like, this is a huge risk for you. You're like, I don't know about this young person. Yeah, we have the Seven of Swords. Could be definitely an Aquarian. We have the Judgment. Yeah, and we have the Death card. I'm thinking you're thinking about ending this air sign, because this person seems to be young. Okay, I'm getting like you're judging this person definitely. You're like, yeah, somebody, this person is sneaky or blah, blah, blah. We do have the Six of Pentacles. All right, maybe it's the way this person speaks, or it could be like their money or something like that. But I'm getting a decision has to be made. You have to decide what you want to do. Do you want to take this risk, or do you want to walk away, or do you want to end it? Okay, what is the Seven of Swords, though? You may think that this person is not being honest with you. All right, what is the Seven of Swords? The Seven of Swords? Yeah, we have the Four of Cups. Yeah, maybe this... Okay. So when we're dealing with love, this is like you're bored with somebody's lies, or you're bored with somebody's aloofness, or you're just bored with the way somebody conducts themselves. Maybe somebody, you feel like somebody's a liar, or like somebody is just too sneaky or judgmental. Okay, but I'm getting like, what's the Judgment card? Yeah, the Knight of Pentacles. Yeah, this is slowing you way down. Whoever this is that you have met, I'm getting like you tried something new, but you're like, no, this is not really for me. I'm cool. I'm good. I'm going to stick to what I know. So this could be a new restaurant. Maybe you're dating somebody new for the first time, or you're dating somebody young, like I said. I'm getting this is like, you're like, no, on second thought, I think I'm going to stick to, like, you know, this age and beyond. What's the Death card? Yeah, we have the Ten of Pentacles. Yeah, so that you might put an ending to something because you feel like somebody doesn't have enough money. Somebody's not established. Okay, or this could be a family situation, but in love, this is usually like money. This could be a sugar daddy, or like somebody who's very wealthy, somebody who has their shit together, you know, all sides. Okay, what's the Page of Swords? Yeah, we have the Knight of Cups. Yeah. But I'm getting like somebody is very sweet. They're approaching you. Somebody is like very charming and sweet. They have a very sweet disposition. All right, so maybe that's why you took the leap of faith. You like this person. There's something about them that's very warm and welcoming. What's the Fool card? But you're not really sure if they can take care of you, or if they can, you know, pay their own way, or if they're established enough, or if they're old enough, if they are mature enough is what I'm seeing. All right, what's the Fool card? Yeah, we have the Magician. Wow, a lot of majors coming out. I'm getting the situation is going to change, or you have the ability to change this person or mold them or something. All right, but maybe you don't really want to do that. You don't want to be with someone that you have to constantly teach and tame and train, and you like show them everything. I'm getting you don't want a partner that you have to like raise is what I'm hearing. All right, especially if it's financially, you don't want someone that you have to take care of, and you have to like, I don't know. It's, you don't want that like teacher student thing, or like mother daughter, mother son thing going on. What's the Magician? All right. So I'm getting to something that you have to think about. You're going to have to think about this from all sides. Yeah, we have the Four of Wands. Okay, maybe this person stays with you, or they're wanting to stay with you. Maybe they don't have their own place. Or I'm getting to, you met this person at your apartment complex or in your neighborhood, and you're like, I don't know. They don't even have their own place or something like that. What's the Four of Wands? All right, I'm getting, if you have not met this person, you're going to meet them in your neighborhood or in your complex or at school or wherever you spend a lot of your time. I'm getting it's going to be around your house or your home or where you shop, groceries, things like that. What's the Two of Wands? Yeah, the Hangman. Okay, so I'm getting, they're telling you to wait. All right, but I'm also hearing to try to see the situation from a different perspective. All right, this is a lesson for you to learn with this person. I'm getting they may not be the most established, or maybe, I don't know, they could be a little bit boring, but I'm getting they are very sweet and genuine. They're a kind person, and there is something to learn. I'm getting this person can help you. Maybe this person is like the maintenance man, or they work where you live or something like that. All right. So let's get some love oracle cards, please. Okay, so we have very soon, yeah. So it's like decide what you want, if you want to date this person or if you want to put them on hold. I wouldn't play any games though, but I mean, I would give it like 2 or 3 dates, or, you know, talk to them, see what, okay, yeah, express your love. See how, you know, talk to them a little bit more or something. Maybe give it more of a chance. You know, give them the benefit of the doubt, if nothing else. Maybe they are young, but I would still give it a chance. And then we have keep an open mind. Yeah, it might not be the usual type of person that you date, but I'm getting the Ten of Pentacles. It could be long-term if you let it go there, all right? So I'm going to leave it there. Hopefully this helps you. Don't forget to like the video, leave your comments, and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye.